few days ago, I shot some scenes with my iPhone 15 using the Blackmagic camera app to see how far I could push my color correction to achieve some sort of cinematographic look with the footage. I was very impressed with the results and the quality, doing something with the color grading that I had never been able to do with a phone before. I filmed with an iPhone 15 Pro Max, and in my Blackmagic camera app, I set ProRes 422 HQ and HDR log. I shot almost all the clips in 60 frames per second, and I set the stabilization to cinematic. So, for this video, I chose this clip, among the others, filmed in ProRes log 24 frames per second. I slowed it down to 50%, and I changed under the video inspector, the retime process, to optical flow and the motion estimation to enhance better to get a smoother playback. In the color tab, I already set a basic empty note 3. And in my project settings, I set DaVinci YRGB to make my color managing in nodes. Time color space, DaVinci Intermediate, and output color space Rec 709A, because I'm using a Mac. On my first transform node, I set as input color space the iPhone color space, Rec 2020, Gamma, Apple log, and as working space DaVinci Intermediate. Tone mapping to none. On my output node coming from DaVinci, input color space and gamma DaVinci, output color space Rec 709, output gamma Rec 709A, tone mapping, luminance mapping and gamut mapping method, saturation compression. Our original image in log, after conversion to a Rec 709. At this point, we are going to make all our color grading adjustments in our color working space DaVinci Intermediate between our two color space transform nodes. This time, for the overall look, film emulation and texture, I'm gonna use the Dehancer plugin. So, I'm gonna create a node before our output node, which we'll label Dehancer, and I'm gonna add it to that node. I'm gonna chance my input source to DaVinci White Gamma, because we are in the DaVinci working space. For the moment, I disable film grain, and for my film emulation, I'm gonna choose as film profile Kodak Chrome 64, and as print profile Kodak 2383. Usually, I change my exposure and contrast in my nodes, but this time I made these adjustments into Dehancer. I set the exposure to 0.7 and the tonal contrast to minus 22. For my saturation, I created an HSV node, setting HSV as color space, disabling the channel 1 and 3 and enabling only the sat in the channel 2. Then, in my primaries, I'm gonna raise the gamma for the saturation up to 0.05. And in my balance node, selecting the HDR node, I'm gonna push, using the global wheel, the color toward a blue cyan tone. Also, I'm gonna raise the color density in the Dehancer node. Then, to get more color separation, I targeted the greens with the HSL qualifier. With my global wheel in HDR mode, I lowered the exposure of the greens and I moved the tone toward yellow. And in my hue versus hue curve, I targeted the yellows and pushed them toward green. On the following node, again with the hue versus hue curve, I pushed the blue color toward a teal tone. And I labeled the node blue. I created a new node to qualify the skin tone. Then, I isolated the subject with a power window. And I pushed the skin tone toward a warm tone. Then I created a new serial node and I added a DCDL plugin to densify the colors. You can download it from the link in the description. It's free. I rose film density to about 0.8 and red to about 300. Finally, I created a node for getting a shallow depth of field. First, I added the depth map to the node. I set the far limit to 0.08. Then I created an outside node in which I added a lens blur effect. I set the effect to 2.8. In my very first node, I added noise reduction to get a clean image. And on the Dehancer node, I added some customized film grain. I also added a bloom effect using the 70mm profile to get a softer effect. So, this is the final results. Thanks for watching.